Hello friends, my name is Ram and I am representing Skillpedia, skillpedia.co. I am bringing you another session. This session is on OpenStack Swift and OpenStack Barbican, two main services, object storage and Barbican. Object storage is like S3 bucket in AWS, object storage in Oracle Cloud, and other service providers in any other cloud service provider have the concept of object storage. And key also, every service provider, cloud service provider, has a concept of secret key management service. So this training, if you want to do OpenStack complete training on Ubuntu or CentOS 8, you can join this course. I've created some scripts which are available on GitHub. I'll show you. github.com, and I've created this. I'm uploading these scripts. You can download the scripts from here, and I'm updating them on regular basis. Right now, if you see, these scripts have been updated 3 days ago, but in the meanwhile I've added two more scripts which I'll be pushing on to this GitHub repository. So this session is about using ready scripts to configure OpenStack Swift. I'm working on CentOS 8 and I'm working on OpenStack Victoria. Let me show you the script first. Setup Swift controller.sh. This script, if you look at, first it is sourcing the credentials the way we have done in the previous lecture. And then after that, it is setting up the database for Swift password, Swift database, and then creating Swift user, then adding role admin to the user, then creating endpoints, service creation, endpoint creation, and after that we are installing the packages. These are packages required for OpenStack Swift, and creating a directory, and then downloading from the repository, Victoria stable repository, downloading the proxyserver.conf file, making changes into the file. This is what you have to do on the controller node, and setting up the configuration file. Very important point is this pipeline part. This is very crucially very important. You cannot change the order, and there are deviation from the default settings. It took me quite some time to identify what all pipelines we require. And let's run the script. So let's run the script now. Setup Swift controller.sh. So creating the database, creating Swift user, linking Swift user service tenant and admin role, creating endpoints, then installing the packages, OpenStack Swift proxy, and then setting the configuration file. That was the job of this script. If you look at just configuring on the controller node, this is the controller node part of it. So last part was up to configuration file. So successfully executed. Now let's move on to the compute node. For the compute node, just to show you, on the compute and storage, these are going to be my storage nodes. So on the storage node, if you see, I have additional disk. This is my SDB and this is my SDC. Two disk I will be using, same on the storage server also, SDB and SDC. Okay, I'll be using these disk for my object storage. So let's go to the object storage on the compute node and let's see the script. Setup Swift dot on the storage node. So this is the script on the for the storage. It is sourcing the files, installing the packages. SDB and SDC are my two devices, making file system on the devices, then mounting the devices after making the directory, making the file system, then creating directory for the mount point, and making entry into FS tab so that these devices are mounted on the system reboot. Remember, We have some additional non-valid, invalid options now, because this is old script, so we don't require any other option other than this no A time, right? Other than this, I'm removing all these options. So these are no more required. So these two options are, this is the only option required, no access time, and then mounting this, and then configuring this rsyncd daemon configuration file, and then setting up this, these are no sections, and entering user ID, Swift, group ID, and IP address, right? And after that, we are configuring account section. Under account section, max connections, path, server node, and these details. And then finally, what we are doing is we are creating the directory, starting the services, and then making a directory if it does not exist, and then downloading the files, installing the packages, downloading this sample file from OpenStack raw branch Victoria, that is account server.conf file, sample file, and then editing these files. This is my account server configuration file, this is my container server configuration file, and this is my object server configuration file. So editing these files, and then changing the ownership, and then making the directory cache, changing the ownership of the directory, and then setting up the firewalls. So these are the settings which we are required to do. Let's run this script to start. Packages are already installed, configuration done, service started, and then downloading the scripts, and then configuring this, and opening the port, successfully completed. Same process, exactly same file we have on the storage node also. Let's open that, vi setup swift on the storage node, and we see that before running the script we make an entry or remove the mount points. So these are few things which we edited on the compute node, and we are removing it on the storage node as well. Now this is the same script, exactly same script, no other details. Now let's run the script, swift on storage node. This will install the packages on the storage node. Once all the packages are installed, it will configure object storage on the storage node. Remember, there are two different machines required for the storage purpose, because it will replicate the data, synchronize the data for the purpose of high availability. And that's how, because the same Swift project is used by Oracle Cloud Infrastructure also. Oracle Cloud Infrastructure storage, object storage, uses same project, OpenStack Swift. And this is how you are configuring OpenStack Swift. So for availability of the data, it is mirroring the data. Two minimum disks are required, and two separate systems are required. So that ensures the availability of the data. So same setting, if you see, and fantastic. So we have done on the storage node, we have done on the compute node. Let's go back to the controller node. On the controller node, we have second script now. Setup Swift controller node part 2. This script now build the rings. This is and after that it will start the services, configure the create the configuration file. So this script is basically going to the directory, building the Swift ring builder, right, using this IP address of my compute node, port number 6202, device SDB SDC, and this is building the ring account builder. We call it as Swift ring builder, running the command Swift ring builder. And similarly, we are running it on the compute node and the storage node IP address. And then after the ring is build is over, we are going to copy the file from the sample, from this URL, the main swift.conf file. We are downloading the configuration file, we are changing the data in configuration file, and then we have to copy the same set of three files by Swift Ring Builder, this will create these configuration, this ZZ file, three files. We have to move them to compute node, and same way on the storage node, ditto copy. Similarly, swift.conf is also need to be copied to the respective nodes, storage and compute, and then changing the ownership. And then we are starting the services on this controller node, and we are starting on compute node and storage node. So this is the whole process of configuring and starting the HTTPD service. So let's run the second script, which will finalize the installation of Swift Object Storage. Script downloading the Swift configuration file, swift.conf file. Okay, now if the file is not found, that means it is not able to reach to the directory. No problem, we'll see that if the files are created here. So let's move these files manually to the respective systems. So scp sudo scp account ring.zz to compute /etc/swift. This will copy this to compute node directory, and similarly we copy this to storage also. Now let's do the same thing for the next file. Next file is, let's say, object container on storage and container on compute. And now the third file, object ring on compute and object compute on storage. Let's see if I have missed anything just by using history command. So copy account ring to compute, account ring to storage, container ring to storage, container ring to compute, etc. Swift object ring to compute, object ring to storage. Fantastic. Now change to root, go to the etc directory /etc swift directory, and here we need to copy this file, main swift.configuration file. So let's take a look at this file, grep hyphen o. I don't want to see any comment, and let's see what is there in this file, swift.configuration file. So one second, swift grep, everything is fine, grep swift.conf, oh hyphen o, that is hyphen o. So all thing perfect. We need to copy the same file swift.conf to storage node and compute node. So scp swift.conf storage /etc/swift. This will copy, and similarly we need to copy it onto the compute node as well. Now let's go to compute node and verify the files are present. We are working on compute node now. Sudo su hyphen cd /etc/swift and use long list. So files are copied properly, and swift.conf is already existing, and ownership is root swift. It should be, for all the files should be root swift. Let's change the ownership, chown hyphen uppercase r root dot swift dot. Yes, that should be the ownership. Let's verify once again on the controller node. So on the controller node also the permissions are not correct. So let's change the permission, chown hyphen r root dot swift dot. All these files should be owned by root, and the files must be present here also, those files which I copied to compute and that. So let's cp /home/home/stack/scripts/centos/. Now here we have the zz file, so object ring dot zz, and copy it here. Similarly, we need to copy that file also. Containerring.gz here, and third, accountring.gz. Accountring, where's that gone? Accountring. So now we have the files available here. All the files, ls-l, verify the ownership. So let's change the ownership once again. Now exit from here, verify the permissions. So here you see the ownership. It should be root swift, etc swift directory should be owned and owned by and root user and swift user. So let's go back and verify on all the three nodes. Sudo su hyphen ch own hyphen r root dot swift then /etc/swift. That should be the command. We need to execute the same command on compute node and controller node as well. Let's do that. There should be no confusion. Yes, let's verify. cd /etc/swift. Use long list. Verify the ownership is perfect. All good. Here also, all good. And on this machine also, on the computer node, controller node, let's verify. Same thing here also, all great. Now what we need to do is we need to start the services. This is compute node. So starting all the services on the compute node, fantastically done. Similarly, starting this on storage node, fantastically done. And finally, restarting the API service on this HTTPD service on controller node. Sudo systemctl restart HTTPD. And after that, we are good to try on the dashboard. We'll just verify once again all the services are up and running. So systemctl status openstack hyphen star, that will show me the status of all the services, heat engine, Nova engine, all the services I can check. There should be no break on any other service. All services are great. And same thing I can verify on my compute and controller node also. I'm working as root systemctl status openstack hyphen star, that will give me all the services, Swift container, Swift account, Swift object storage, all great. And same thing I will try on my compute node also. So systemctl status openstack hyphen star, all the services are running here also. So that means I'm ready to verify on my system Horizon dashboard. Let's verify OpenStack Swift, OpenStack Object Storage Swift service on the Horizon dashboard. So here we see Object Storage team. You can see that Object Store containers. Let's create a container. Policy unable to get the Swift service information. Okay, let's start the service. I believe we need to restart our service on the controller node, and the service is let me get the service name. That service needs to be started. One second, because after this is built we need to restart the service. This service we need to restart. No problem, we'll restart and we'll verify that. So let's restart. Hopefully after that message will be gone. And now we'll verify. Okay. Error connecting to memcache. Let me start. Okay, let me start again. Restart. Status. Now everything is running. Let me verify now. And probably we also need to restart HTTPD also. Okay, now there is no error. Error is gone. Let's create a container. Container 1. Public. Container created. Click on container. And you see it is disabled, public access is disabled. And let's create a folder also here, TSP folder, create folder, and we can upload the content here inside this upload data. Let's create a file or upload some file here. For example, I just want to upload this file and upload it. So you see my object storage is working fine. Object storage is installed properly. Some hiccups always there, service not started or restart the service. Otherwise I tried and tested it before I started the demonstration. Now you can download it, you can change the folder, you can work with the containers and objects inside the container. Let's move on to the next part. Second session, second topic is the Barbican. Barbican is a security or secret management list or key management system where it can be used to generate symmetric and asymmetric both type of keys which are used to encrypt the data at rest. So for that I have the script is ready. Let me show you the scripts. Barbican server, and this is updated based on Victoria requirement, OpenStack Victoria. So let's take a look at the script. Sourcing the credentials, username and password for the database, installing the packages, and then admin credentials, and then creating services and endpoints, and after that, after endpoint creation, configuration file. This is configuration file details. It is similar on the same lines. If you have watched my previous lecture, it is on the same line. Then creating a file. If the file does not exist, we have to create this file and we have to put this content. This is again not given in even in the guide. There is no documentation available after train release of OpenStack. So I have modified this and changed as per Python 3 requirement. Barbican manage database upgrade, starting the services, restarting HTTPD and verifying the secrets and all. So this is a key management system, Barbican. Let's set up this. So this is creating the database, packages installation, service creation, user role adding to the admin role, adding endpoints, and configuration file, creating service restarted. So this way we have created the Barbican secret management or Barbican key management system for OpenStack. So once the service is HTTP, right now it is restarting HTTP. You know that HTTP restart takes time, because before Barbican, it is before HTTPD, it has restarted Barbican Keystone Listener, and a symbolic link is also created. All is good. So far, so good. Let's see if the script fail at some point. Hopefully, it will run through. And once that, yes, showing Barbican secret list. Now we can see here if the user interface is available for Barbican, we can see that here. And meanwhile it is checking the list of secrets, because as of now there is no secrets available, we will not get anything. So let's see. Yes, it is creating the secret. Fantastic. You see here, so nothing was there. Getting a token, success, token is available. Now using Barbican client, creating a secret, HREF, showing name secret. So this is testing my script and is working fantastic, deleting the secret. So team, this has successfully installed and verified the Barbican key management system on OpenStack. So we have completed successfully two services today. One is object storage, Swift, and second is key management system, Barbican, we configured these two on the system today. And you can see under identity, you can see the project and users and group and roles and the URLs, API endpoints also. So thank you for thank you very much for watching. And for any training on these technologies, I deliver corporate training on many technologies, which you can see on my website, skillpedia.co. You see all courses, go to all courses, and you see the courses and trainings I deliver, the technologies I deliver. And these are my technologies, DevOps, particularly Ansible, Terraform, Kubernetes, Jenkins, Business Analysis, Linux is my forte, SE Linux, Security Enhanced Linux. So thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.